Hello and welcome to the San Francisco Beat. I'm Erica Sandberg. This is the show about everything that's going on in San Francisco and sometimes a little bit beyond. But really, when it comes down to it, the things that happen in San Francisco affect the rest of the nation. We tend to be sort of a focal point. Because of that, the emphasis in the next couple of months is going to be on getting everybody who's running for San Francisco office, in whatever capacity, on the show and to explain what they're doing, why they jumped in, and what they hope to attain. Because of that, somebody who's running for mayor is here. His name is Mark Farrell. You probably heard of him because he actually used to be mayor for a very short period of time, but he's jumping back in into the race, and it is heating up. Mark, thank you so much for heading out here and those right after the big election last night.
That's right. Well, thanks for having me, Erica.
You're welcome. And so let's just start with where you see right now the city going after what happened with the election, which was we had some pretty interesting measures that were passed. Is there anything there that gave you, oh, thank goodness, we're in the right direction sort of feeling?
Yeah, I think last night was a great night for the city of San Francisco. We see, you know, ballot measures, but in particular, we saw candidates for the Democratic County Central Committee, a really moderate slate of candidates for San Francisco terms win the election. And while their votes to be counted, super optimistic about the end results. And it's really about a shift in momentum here in the city of San Francisco. We've seen candidates over the past few years, Brooke Jenkins come in as a district attorney after recalling Chesa Boudin. We saw a school board recall because school board members weren't focusing on kids, they were focusing on renaming schools. Right now we see common sense candidates come into office in the city of San Francisco. I think it's just a sense of the right direction that we're going in.
Well, which alludes to us that we were in the wrong direction for a while.
Yes.
The wrong direction was kind of what, and I'd love to get a summary of that. Like, what was going so wrong, in your opinion?
Look, the whole reason I'm running for mayor is because over the last 6 years, I have seen our city crumble right in front of our eyes. Public safety has never been a bigger concern. The conditions of our streets have never been worse. Our local economy has completely hit the skids, and we're the butt of jokes, and have been the butt of jokes, across the country and abroad. And that has to stop. We cannot afford, as a city, another 4 years of the same leadership or lack of leadership. And we can't afford somebody to come in and simply learn on the job. Why I'm running for mayor and what I bring to the table is 7.5 year track record inside of City Hall of effective leadership. I grew our police department. We cleaned up the tents on our streets. We invested in our local economy. And when I left office as mayor in 2018, San Francisco was in a much better, much different place than it is today. But what I also bring to the table, and believe it or not, I'm the only candidate in this race that has ever worked a single year in the private sector. So for me, I started my career as a lawyer for 3 years in Silicon Valley, became an investment banker for over 5 years, and started my investment firm in 2009. So I've spent over 20 years as a business and finance professional, in addition to serving as a lawyer for 3 years. That's the type of experience combined with City Hall experience that will allow me to hit the ground running day one. And I believe that's exactly what we need here in San Francisco.
Well, and that's actually a really nice segue into the business sector and about what is happening. I've been going over and over again with different people. I'm like, is anybody caring about this? We have lost so much in our downtown area, the financial district, Union Square. It's basically collapsed. I would love some specifics, if you can, as details as you can, is what would you do? How could you help bring this back up to what it needs to be? Even if it's creative ideas, I'm down. Hit me with what you think would help. Because this is where, well, a couple of reasons. It's a point of pride. Right, which
yes.
I know that you do talk about, which is great, but it's also a point of finance, revenue. What would you do?
Well, first of all, let's set the stage in where we are, and let's be honest with the residents of San Francisco. Our city right now ranks dead last in major U.S. cities of economic recovery since COVID. dead last.
Why?
We were never
part
of that conversation.
What happened? What was the breakdown? What was the breakdown? I mean, I have some ideas, but what do you think the breakdown was?
Look, I've talked to people in many different cities across our country. You know, when COVID was raging in the beginning in New York City, they were already working behind closed doors on a resiliency plan post-COVID. It took us over 3 years to even get our act together, and the plans failed. So what we need out of City Hall and what we can have continued to see over the last 6 years is failed leadership, and now what we're seeing is the results of failed leadership.
Uh-huh.
An empty downtown, a market street with crickets, Union Square being dismantled piece by piece, and now with Macy's leaving, as someone who's lucky enough to be born and raised here in San Francisco, that's a real gut punch because that's part of growing up here in our city and an iconic institution in San Francisco. So we have such a long road to go, but I will tell you, a big part of running for mayor is because I believe I have the background that can actually make a difference.
Okay. Well, let's go to the whole Macy's issue, because it really did. It is amazing how important that is. Yeah. That issue really, I think, took a lot of people by surprise, but it was not a surprise. It was not a surprise. Apparently, Macy's corporate did go back to City Hall, did go to City Hall, did say, we need help. There's something going wrong. We are flooded with problems, theft, assaults, difficulties within our store. Our employees were having were scared to go into work.
Right.
So, if this is true, which I know it is, the government didn't take action.
Right.
If you were mayor,
yeah,
during that time, what would you have done? Because I heard that it fell on deaf ears.
Yeah.
Right?
It's so important, first of all, to have a mayor that's engaged with every community in San Francisco, especially our business community.
Uh-huh.
You know, what we've had over the last 6 years is complete disengagement. And there used to be a mantra, a feeling that companies and businesses would be here because they have to be, because
right,
it's San Francisco. And what we're seeing now is that argument is collapsing and it's falling on deaf ears. So what we can't afford is have a city hall and a mayor's office that turns their backs to the issues that our employers are facing here in San Francisco. You know, we heard the same sentiment coming out of Nordstrom's when they shut down.
Yes, for sure.
Complaints over the years falling on deaf ears inside of City Hall. So what we need is a mayor's office that's super engaged with our business community, that articulates very publicly, look, we value our employers. We value what they bring to the city. We value the vibrancy. We value the jobs. We value the tax revenue. Every single reason why we need employers back into the downtown core is because it also brings employees back. It brings vibrancy back to our city. It brings tourism back to our city. And you know what? It funds a lot of the programs that the rest of San Francisco depends on.
Right.
And so what I would do, what would I have done differently? First of all, public safety is the number one issue in our city.
Mm-hmm.
I mentioned to you, I served as the longest budget chair in our city's history for 4 years in City Hall, partnered with Mayor Lee at the time. And then when I became mayor after he passed away, we grew our police department to record levels. Over the last 6 years, we have lost over 25% of our police department, and we have not replaced them. In addition, we've cut the police department budget.
Mm-hmm.
In addition, we cannot recruit now. As budget chair and as mayor, we average 5 police academy classes every single year with over 50 recruits. We were turning people away at the door. Right now, over the past 6 years, the current mayor's averaged 3 police academy classes, and the last one only had 19 recruits.
Yeah.
By the way, at the same point in time, we have over 600 applicants in background check backlog that this City Hall administration has not cleared out. That is completely insane from my point of view.
Okay, so there's that saying, which is, well, what is it? Where does it break down? Is it incompetence? Is it not caring? Or is it deliberate? And, you know, it kind of really makes you wonder, like, well, how bad is it? Like, where are we with this? I mean, I look at Westfield Mall, now back to Emporium Mall.
Right.
Because Westfield departed.
Right.
And I'm watching it be depleted by the minute. I think we're roughly 50% right now occupancy,
yeah,
at that mall. And it kind of makes you wonder, is this the plan? Or is it just that they just couldn't get their lives together? So I'm not gonna bash the current administration
right
too much, but it really makes you wonder, we cannot have this. And one of the reasons that we can't have it, as you mentioned, is because it funds, these are the businesses that fund what we want to do.
Yeah, look, our local business taxes are a big part of our revenue in the city of San Francisco.
Right.
Property taxes are the number one driver for sure. But you know, what we have seen time and time again, whether it's our police department shrinking and losing budget dollars, whether it's the tents that have once again proliferated on our street, whether it's a lack of engagement in our business community, it's a blanket lack of leadership. We need a mayor that's engaged, that understands the issues facing our city, and that gets back to basics. You know, I talk about, and I have talked about over the last 3 weeks since I launched my campaign, mm-hmm. a big part of the reason I'm running is for my own family and for families across San Francisco. Because my daughter, our eldest of our three children, is going off to college next year. I want her to come home to San Francisco when she graduates. But right now, this is not a city that young graduates are coming to. It was in 2018 when I left office. Mm-hmm. People were flocking to the city of San Francisco. Right now, that's not the case. We need to turn our city around for families, for the next generation of San Franciscos.
You think you can do it?
Absolutely.
Okay. I mean, that's the kind of confidence we do want, which is great. Working with the Board of Supervisors.
Yeah.
That's going to be a challenge. We don't know who they're going to be, mm-hmm. because obviously that also is in transition. But it can be a really thorny, difficult, bureaucratic kind of nightmare to work with a Board of Supervisors who are going to oppose what the mayor believes. It's hard to round everybody up. Do you have any ideas about how you're going to be able to get a more kind of comprehensive, let's go, let's get the city in order?
Absolutely. This is where experience comes in.
Yeah.
You know, I served as supervisor for 7 years, as a leader within that, as the budget chair for 4 years, and then as mayor. I've been in both shoes. And I will tell you that no matter where you sit in a political spectrum, it is your job to engage with people across the aisle, not just with people that you agree with all the time, mm-hmm. and work to find common ground. I did that as supervisor and as mayor. We passed legislation to protect mental health mm-hmm. and families with mental health issues in Laura's Law. We got pension reform done with labor unions, things that were third rails, but it's because we invested the time to work with my colleagues across the aisle. Issues that were the third rail of politics for decades in San Francisco, we actually got done because we invested the time to work together. We agreed we would not see eye to eye on 95% of the issues. But let's work on that 5% and let's make a difference for the residents of San Francisco. Mm-hmm. As mayor, I did the same thing. And so it's critically important to have that attitude and that engagement level, because guess what? That's what we're paid for in City Hall, is to engage. What we see now is bomb throwing between the mayor's office and the Board of Supervisors. Mm-hmm. That does not lead to results. That leads to excuses. And again, this lack of leadership we've seen out of City Hall is excuses. We blame the Board of Supervisors. We blame the police commission. We blame anybody we can except for the mayor's office and the mayor, him or herself, standing up and saying, I'm the leader of this city. This is my vision. Here's how I'll get there. The buck stops here. You can hold me accountable. We have not seen that type of leadership out of City Hall in 6 years, and we are sorely missing it.
Okay, I agree. Now let's talk about police commission, because you did mention it, mm-hmm. and you talk a lot about public safety.
Yep.
And the police commission are making decisions that are affecting the way the San Francisco Police Department can function.
Yep.
Do you have any thoughts on that, about how you would rein that in? Because it's pretty acrimonious right now.
Yeah, 100%. So first of all, under the current rules, mm-hmm. the mayor has the majority of the appointments. If an appointee turns an about face or starts to enact policies or push procedures that don't reflect the mayor's will or the will of the public, mm-hmm. it's on the mayor. That's his or her appointee. And you have to accept the blame for that, and you can take the success if that person is doing their job. That hasn't happened over the last 6 years. But second of all, I'm going to put an early plug in for two charter reform measures that will be on the ballot in November.
Oh, let's hear it.
One is going to be shrinking the amount of commissions that exist inside of City Hall.
We have how many?
I believe it's 120 something right now.
A lot of commissions.
Crazy and unnecessary.
Yes.
But second of all, one that will give the mayor greater latitude to hire and fire department heads, as well as the commissioners that they appoint. Right now, our system exists where commissioners are literally not accountable to the public for the life of their terms, which is in most cases 4 years. That, especially in the right commission, can do an incredible amount of damage to the city of San Francisco. Good governance says we change that. We need to hold them accountable like we hold everybody else accountable.
Okay. Would you do anything creative? And when I'm going to say that, and this is a weird question, but it's kind of like, oh, you know, we can all talk about bringing business back. Is there anything that you've just kind of, there's something in you and you think, you know, I've always wanted to do this, or this would really help San Francisco. Is there anything off the top of your head or that you've been thinking about that would say, San Francisco's back? Here's what, you know, whether it's, I don't know, throwing a parade or gathering people, I don't care, something where you just go, we need a jolt. We need a big kind of like swig of coffee and go. Is there anything that you think, oh, I would do this? Celebrate restaurants that are doing really well. I don't care. Is there something that you think, oh, if only?
100%, we'll get to that. But I really do believe we have to be honest with the residents of San Francisco. Mm-hmm. First and foremost, the job is not to celebrate. The job is to get back to basics and take care of the hard work, the blocking and tackling that we've missed over 6 years. To me, government's fundamental job is to protect our residents. Okay. Whether it's at the federal level or the local level. We are not doing that in San Francisco right now.
Well, protecting residents, if you talk about SFPD, finding people to actually become police officers is going to be a challenge. So that is something that, you know, hopefully we can inspire people to say this is going to be a career.
Well, look, 100%. You know, I've talked about in my campaign, I do believe we need a new police chief. Mm-hmm. Look, Chief Scott's a good man, without a doubt. But the average tenure of a police chief in a major U.S. city is 3 years. He's been here over 6 years. Arguably a department that hasn't been able to do its job, a department that's empirically lost budget share, and a department that has lost over 25% of its workforce, and a department that can't recruit. In my job in the private sector, any CEO that fit that profile presiding over a department or a company, there has to be change of leadership. So we need a chief of police, but we also need a mayor that is going to publicly articulate a belief in law enforcement and the personnel that man our departments, whether it's police, fire, sheriffs, 911 operators, and the rest. We need a mayor that's going to sit up publicly and say, we value law enforcement. Thank you for doing your jobs. Thank you for protecting the residents of San Francisco. This is a career to believe in. We have definitely not seen that over the last 6 years. It's part of why we can't recruit new officers into town. What I will do is completely change that idea in San Francisco.
Okay, good. And you do believe in minimum staffing levels?
100%. I believe in, look, we've lost over 500 officers, close to 600 officers from our police force. We have a long road to go to get back to where it was in 2018 when I left office. But that is job one.
Okay. All right. So if that's job one, what's job two?
Job two is cleaning up our streets.
Oh.
You know.
What, our streets are dirty? Is this what you're trying to say?
Look, when I was mayor, tenant encampments were flourishing. We took out all of the large tenant encampments within 6 months, and I will do it again.
Mark, how are you going to do it?
But let me talk about how we did it and what the focus is, because it also goes to the drug crisis we see on our streets right now. As mayor, we went to the tenant encampments. We treat these individuals with compassion, because they are sons and daughters, as they are sons and daughters on the drug crisis on our streets. We offer them shelter. We offer them housing. We get them and do everything we can to get them off the streets into a situation where they can either sober up, clean up, get connected with services, and hopefully get on to a better life.
Right.
I firmly believe no one is getting better by sleeping in a tent at night. But if these individuals say no, if these individuals choose to live in our streets, we will take their tents away, we will keep and hold on to their personal belongings, and we make it inconvenient for them to stay on the sidewalks forever.
That's a very radical approach compared to what has been going on for a long time. And the coalition on homelessness has been a major roadblock. How are you going to deal with these stalwarts? You know, they've been in power for so long and have had undue influence. What would you do? Because you're going to have to battle that. They're actually already saying that they're going to sue the city over Prop F. It was Prop F, right? About testing for mm-hmm. addiction or drug use before giving cash. You got a lot. These are big issues with people who are like going to, they're going to pick up their weapons and they're going to fight. How are you going to deal with that?
That's where having a successful track record on these issues matters.
Okay.
In 2018 as mayor, I took out our large tent encampments within uh-huh. 6 months. We got people connected to shelter and services. But we also gained a reputation as a city that was not going to allow permanent tent encampments to exist on our corners and on our streets. And you know what? That worked. Over time, San Francisco right now, once again, is gaining a reputation of allowing this to flourish. Mm-hmm. And we'll get to the drug crisis in a second. But we've gained a reputation that we permit this type of behavior
because
on our streets. Because we do. But we didn't when I was mayor.
Right.
We didn't. We tackled that issue. And we can do it again. And we will do it again. But it takes someone with experience and a backbone to come in and say, I don't care what the protests are. I don't care about all of the nonprofits that are going to come after me. Mm-hmm. What I care about is getting these individuals the help that they need. And as a byproduct, we also clean up the streets of San Francisco. I fully believe the sidewalks of our city belong to everybody. They belong to the family that walks their child to the Muni bus stop in the morning to go to school. Mm-hmm. That family shouldn't have to walk around tents, needles, feces on our corners. No way. It belongs to the elderly in our commercial corridors mm-hmm. that just want to shop at their local grocery store. They shouldn't have to wander out into the street to do that. San Francisco has always been a compassionate city. We will take that approach with these individuals sleeping in tents, but we will not permit them to be there as long as they want.
Yeah.
And as we talk about our drug crisis, just to shift to that.
Well, because they're one and the same and very often they're one in the same.
They touch on the same issues for sure, and it's the same approach. And again, a complete existence of failed leadership over the past 6 years. Look, the drug crisis today is completely different than the drug crisis 10 years ago, 20 years ago. Fentanyl has changed the game, mm-hmm. without a doubt. But how we treat it, how we deal with it, hasn't. Take a walk through the Tenderloin and the surrounding areas. During the day, let alone at night, it is a scary situation. And what we are doing is not working.
Right.
The only reason I am running for office is to challenge the status quo. I was blessed with a great career outside of City Hall, blessed with an amazing family. This is not something I woke up last year and crawled out of bed and said, you know what, I want to be mayor of San Francisco mm-hmm. again. This is only to come in and change our city and get us back on track again. How we have to handle fentanyl is completely different than we always did before. You know, last week I was in the Tenderloin walking around with a number of people who had actually recovered from fentanyl abuse, fentanyl addiction on our streets, gotten better. And these individuals pointed out a shopping cart that the city of San Francisco is paying for, where individuals are walking around the Tenderloin handing out free drug paraphernalia.
Yes.
And you watch an individual, because of the nature of fentanyl, you have to shoot up generally every 2 hours. You watch an individual hunched over, grab a pack of tinfoil, go over to the next corner, smoke some fentanyl, and pass out on the streets. Mm-hmm. That's not compassionate. That's not progressive.
It's bizarre.
That's not the city of San Francisco and the city of St. Francis that I grew up in. Mm. We need to get these individuals the help that they need, that requires intervention, that requires the city of San Francisco taking a more active approach and not letting these individuals wallow on our streets. It is so incredibly sad that so many of these individuals that look much older than the 20s and 30s that they are simply left to their own devices in the Tenderloin and the surrounding areas. It's bad for them. It's a black eye for the city of San Francisco. We simply need to do better, and we need to do it differently.
Okay, well, we have just a couple minutes left, and these half hours just fly by when you're talking to somebody who's super passionate, and there's so much to say.
Yes.
So, on that note, the vision for San Francisco.
Yeah.
Give me your vision. Like, what does it look like to you? There you are, you get elected. Then what would you, I mean, you could even do like paint a picture about
sure.
what you want others to see and what you want the community to see.
That's a great question, and a question that doesn't get asked often enough. We certainly haven't seen it for 6 years in City Hall. So here's my vision for the city of San Francisco. It's a city that's safe for residents, for visitors, for those that work in our city. It's a city with clean streets that believes the sidewalks are for everybody. It's a city with a growing economy and a city hall that engages with our business community. It's a city that focuses on families once again and believes a large part of what we're doing is to build for the next generation of San Francisco residents. And a city with vibrant neighborhoods. I fully believe the heart and soul of our city is found in our neighborhoods. And it doesn't matter if it's West Portal, the Castro, the Mission, Third, the Marina, North Beach. It doesn't matter. The beauty of our cities and the diversity of our neighborhoods. And those thriving neighborhoods are suffering right now. Mm-hmm. Small businesses are going out of business. Windows are shuttering. The for lease space is absolutely incredible. We need to do a lot to turn our city around. But if we can do it, we can unlock the promise of what has always been one of the most iconic cities in the world. Mm-hmm. And I firmly believe as mayor, not only can I do the job, but I am very clear about my vision, the roadmap, and I want to be held accountable.
Okay, well, you just may have that chance. Thank you so much for joining me. This is, you know, the start of something new. And boy, I hope it's the start of something wonderful because we really do need it and we deserve it. Where can people get in touch with you?
Our website, www.markfarrell.com. We have all contact information there. You can contribute online, take out a window sign, get in contact with our campaign staff. We are very fortunate, not only the team we've built, the amount of volunteers, contributors, people putting up those window signs throughout the city of San Francisco in just 3 weeks is absolutely amazing. Come join our team. Let's change the city of San Francisco.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Erica.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for joining today and listening to another candidate who is hopefully going to stick it through to the end of this election because it's getting pretty crazy out here. If you have any questions for Mark Farrell, please reach out to him. You can certainly ask through the contact form there. As for me, if you have questions about the election or anything about San Francisco, you know I welcome it. On that note, I'm Erica Sandberg. Until next time, bye.